Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today's video is based on chapter Nelson Mandela, Long Walk to Freedom. This is a chapter in class 10th CBSE NCERT book First Flight. And with the help of this video, I am going to explain this chapter to you. So the chapter begins with the introduction. The chapter is an extract from the autobiography of Nelson Mandela. Now, what is autobiography? When a person writes something about his own life and it is published in the form of any book or blogs, it is known as autobiography. Means it is written by a person about his own life. Generally, we read or we study autobiographies of various famous people. So this is the autobiography of Nelson Mandela named Long Walk to Freedom. And a part of that autobiography is here in front of you in the form of a chapter. So Nelson Mandela is the first black president of South Africa. Black president means black skinned person. And this chapter is an excerpt, means a part of his autobiography, Long Walk to Freedom. That includes the description of the inauguration ceremony of Nelson Mandela. Inauguration ceremony means the ceremony on the day on which he was sworn as the president of South Africa, first black president. Citations from his speech, the speech that he gave that day, some parts of those speech are also included in this chapter. His journey as a freedom fighter. Now, why is he considered as a freedom fighter? That we'll get to know in the coming part of the video. His struggles and his tribute to other freedom fighters and countless people who supported him. In South Africa, a brutal system was practiced. That is the system of apartheid. Now, what is the system of apartheid? Apartheid refers to discrimination between people on the basis of their race. Race means jati and racism means jatiwad. Now, we all know that this is quite illegal. But in those days, this thing was followed in South Africa. And the fair-skinned or the white people were in power. And they used to consider themselves superior, and the black-skinned people were used to considered inferior to them. And that is why this apartheid system was followed, where the people who are in power, the supremacy, those were generally the white-skinned people, and they always considered these black-skinned people to be below them or inferior to them. And these people are deprived of their basic rights, the dark-skinned people. They were not even given the basic rights of living. This lesson gives us an overview of how Nelson Mandela, with the help of others, carved a society with no discrimination on basis of color, caste, race, age, and gender. He was the first black-skinned president, and his whole sole motive was to create such a society in South Africa which is free from discrimination based on color, caste, gender, anything like that. Okay. So now I am starting with the explanation of the chapter. I have already given you an introduction. So 10th May was the day when Nelson Mandela was sworn as the first black head of the state. 10th May, South Africa. Okay. It was after years of struggle that his anti-racist party came into power. Anti-racist party means he was against racism. And now, through democracy, his party is in power. Until then, this seat, means the political seats, were always occupied by white presidents. That is why the author refers to the day as bright and clear. Clarity, no disparity. It was morning full of hope. Days before this date, many notable personalities started congratulating him for the victory. Now you see, if these type of things happen, like when PM Narendra Modi won the elections, not only the people of India, but people throughout the world congratulated him. Same thing happened with Nelson Mandela also, that people throughout the world start congratulating him or appreciating him when he was about to come in power. For the first time in history of South Africa, so many international leaders were coming together to South Africa to witness the inauguration ceremony or the oath-taking ceremony of this president. The ceremony took place in an open circular building made of sandstone consisting of union buildings in the Pretoria city. Pretoria is the name of city where there is this building known as amphitheater. Now, just to understand what kind of building this is, I am giving you a comparison to a cricket stadium. You have seen cricket stadium. They are developed in circular form stands throughout the circle for the people to sit, but from top they are open. There is no covering on the roof. You can see sunlight, you can witness rain, air, everything. Similarly, this is the circular building amphitheater, which is open from the top, and it is situated in Pretoria, where this ceremony is going to take place. Clear? So on this day, Nelson Mandela was accompanied by his daughter, and the name of the daughter is Zenani. First, the two vice presidents took an oath. You know, you have to follow a hierarchy level where the vice president will first take the oath and then finally the president will take the oath. Then when his turn came, his means Nelson Mandela's turn. Now, one more thing, that this thing is a part of an autobiography. So it is written in first person context. That means wherever you will see I, me, that is referred to Mandela himself. Okay. So then when his turn came, his means Mandela, he committed to respect, protect and abide by the constitution and to devote his entire self into the welfare of the country. Now, you know, before taking the post, the president, vice president or any official, they take an oath, and in that oath they promise to abide by the constitution and always work for the welfare of the nation. So the same oath is taken by Nelson Mandela, where he's been sworn as the first black president of South Africa. Now, the speech that was given by Nelson Mandela on that day, on the inauguration ceremony, many parts of that speech have been shared in this chapter, which are as follows. The author mentions some part of his speech where he said that everyone by his presence was giving rise to hope for a new beginning. Means he is appreciating everybody who is present over there to witness this ceremony, and he is saying that this will give hope to a new beginning. He is saying that the previous rulers means the politicians who were in power, were discriminatory, means they followed discrimination and lasted for long. But the ones who are given the opportunity to rule now, means he's talking about himself, the ANC, African National Congress. African National Congress is the political party which was head by Nelson Mandela. He's saying now we would stand up, the ANC would stand up against this discrimination. He was glad to host the ceremony with the presence of global leaders. I told you that leaders throughout the world were present over there. It was an achievement in itself. There was a time when South Africa was practicing apartheid. Now, I already told you what is apartheid. Apartheid is a system of discrimination. Lost all his international political relationships. Now, no country want to keep their relationships with such a country which follows these type of brutal practices like dictatorship, apartheid. So, obviously, when this system was being followed in Africa, it costed Africa a lot of things, and most of the time Africa was not approached by various countries for various democratic political relations, and it also affected its economy. But now Nelson Mandela is saying they have come to power and they pledge to make everyone proud. He thanked everybody, especially the international leaders, for joining them and celebrating their achievement, which is a step towards an equal society where all humans will be treated fairly. And he will open the routes to international political relationships and trade, which will help South Africa to develop economically, financially and all the other ways. Okay. Now, whenever a politician comes in power, he makes some promises to the public in the speech. And Nelson Mandela also on his inauguration ceremony through the stage announced made some announcements, and those announcements are as follows. He mentions that after great struggle, they have finally achieved political freedom. His government promised to everyone that they will take care of the poverty situation in the country. They will take care of the hardships and inequalities of all kind, along with assuring everyone of a country where no community will be considered inferior. So he said, we promise that we will completely finish the poverty, the hardships of the people, the inequalities that are there in the system, and no community will be considered inferior in our nation from now onwards. He exclaims that freedom should rule, and he also asked God to bless South Africa. So we move forward with the explanation of the chapter. just after the newly elected president addressed to the audience, means when his speech was over, an impressive arrangement of fighter jets, helicopter and soldier transporters raised everyone's head up in the sky. Now we have all seen this on Republic Day, that the Air Force through fighter jets, helicopters make some mesmerizing positions in the sky, and they also spray colors. Generally those colors are the colors of the national flag, the tricolors. So here also something like this happened, and impressive arrangement of fighter jets was there. It symbolized perfection as well as military respect and obedience towards the free country. This also shows that military has also accepted Mandela's government, and it is showing its respect to the country. The high commanders who have won medals for their bravery also saluted and promised their loyalty. Now you know that president is the head of the army. He is the commander of the army, and so the big army officers also saluted him. Now here a very interesting thing is said by Mandela. Mandela says that he was well aware that these commanders who were saluting him now would have arrested him under the previous rule, as during the oppressive white supremacy. Why? Because previously he was against the government, and if you are doing anything against the government, you are considered as outlaw. Outlaw means a person who does not follow law or who breaks law, and whenever you do something like that, the government has full power to arrest you and put you behind the bars. So this is what he is saying, that previously when he and his party members were the freedom fighters who were fighting against this discrimination, then these are the same people who would have very happily locked him up in a cell. But today, as he is the president, they all are saluting him. How time changes, isn't it? He was considered to be a criminal previously. The air show finally ended by making the South African flag in the sky from smoke beneath the jets. Like here, when you see in Republic Day, tricolors are being sprayed by the planes and jet aircraft. Similarly, there they have sprayed or thrown the colors of the South African flag. Okay. Nelson Mandela also remembers the inauguration ceremony by writing in his autobiography that day was unique in one sense, that day two national anthems were played in the country. Now because of the discrimination, the white people and the black people had their separate national anthems which they used to sing, but that day both the national anthems were sung, one of the white people and the other was of the black people. On that day no one knew the wordings of the anthem of the black people because it was being sung publicly for the first time. But Mandela was confident that everyone would soon learn this anthem that they hated once in the past. So you see that from the first day only he is trying to show everybody that everyone is equal, and he included the black people's national anthem in that ceremony. Okay. Now we move ahead with the explanation, and it's mentioned, on the day of the inaugural ceremony, the author was remembering the days of past, when this whole system of apartheid emerged, when this system was prevalent in the nation, apartheid. It resulted in inequality and inferior treatment of the dark-skinned people. Inequality and dark-skinned people were treated in an inferior way. Matlab jo black textured hote the, jinka skin color kala hota tha, उनको हमेशा inferior या नीचा समझा जाता था. उन दिनों को याद कर रहा है मंडेला. They were deprived of their basic fundamental rights. Now what are the basic fundamental rights? Every country's constitution lays some basic fundamental rights which are there for every citizen, no matter if he is black or white. But then in those days when the apartheid system was followed, the black Africans were not given these fundamental rights. As a result, one of the world's most brutal means very ruthless, merciless, an inhuman society was born. This began even before he was born. This system was there in Africa even before the birth of Nelson Mandela. This system created an atmosphere of extreme cruelty and injustice for a particular part of the community. Which part was being harmed by this system? The black, dark-skinned people, particularly them. Now when he is in his eighth decade as a man. Means now when Nelson Mandela in his 80s, one decade is equal to 10 years. So eighth decade means when he's in his 80s, means he's quite old. He, along with countless others, have changed this entire system by becoming the president. That treats humans as human, irrespective of their color, caste, gender, or age. Means now the system that they are developing is free from apartheid. Everybody will be considered as human, whether he is black, whether he is from inferior caste, or anything like that. Okay? So we move ahead with the explanation. This equal and free country was a result of sacrifice of countries, other men and women who have fought all their lives for this day. Now, obviously, any big change demands sacrifice. For example, now today India is a free nation, but we can never forget the sacrifice of our great freedom fighters who have given their life for us. Similarly, he's saying that this change in South Africa came at a cost of sacrifice of various life of men and women who supported Mandela as freedom fighters. The author wishes if he could thank them, but unfortunately they didn't live to see the result of their courage because they are all dead. Nelson Mandela gathered his courage and power from all these people, and thus by this government he wishes to make them proud for their sacrifices. Moreover, he says that this oppression policy, oppression means when some people who are in power try to rule the other peoples and discriminate them from others. Like people who are in power oppress the others, ya dusre jo unse niche hain unko daba ke rakhna. It is known as oppression. So previously the white people used to rule as oppressors. So he's saying the oppression policy scared many peoples, and it will take a long time for them to move on, because the system of apartheid was being followed for many years, and now it is a beginning of a new change. The author mentions that this hard time had its negative impact, but it also exposed a lot of strong and courageous men who stood up and raised their voice. Now he's appreciating the efforts of the people who has supported him. And in the chapter, if you see on one page, the name of these people are given with their photos, passport size photographs. Thus, it requires the level of unjust treatment to produce such great heroes. Means they came out of this operation of these circumstances and they become hero. South Africa, he says, is rich in mineral and gems. But the greatest strength of South Africa lies in its people. People who helped Africa to become a better nation. Now, it is a long chapter, and if I try to cover it up in one video, the video will be too long. And so, I will be stopping this video over here, and I am going to make a second part of the video where we are going to continue with the chapter. If you like the video and you think it is going to help you in understanding the chapter in a better way, like the video, subscribe the channel, and tell me in comment section that what else you want, or give your response as to how you like the video. Thank you very much.